What's up everyone, Nick here once again from TV Boxed Up. Today I'm very excited to review a new Windows Mini PC from Minix. Minix, usually known for their quality Android boxes, has now ventured into Windows Mini PCs. This is the Minix Neo Z100 0 dB Windows 11 fanless mini PC. As the name implies, this mini PC does not use an internal cooling fan, but a robust massive heatsink for silent cooling operation. It runs on the latest 12th generation Intel Alder Lake N100 processor with all the modern I/O ports. So if you would like to see what this mini PC has to offer, my full review is up next. Stay tuned. So I'm back after that quick unboxing. So in the box you get the Z100 mini PC. You get a VESA mounting bracket and screws, one HDMI cable, a pair of external antennas, a 12 volt 3 amp DC power supply with interchangeable plug pins for US, EU and UK regions, and a multi-language user manual. So for design and I/O, this mini PC feels very heavy in your hands, and that is due to its 1 cm thick heatsink at the top, along with its metal housing. There is also a sticker indicating that you should avoid touching the surface while in use. You should place it where it can get adequate airflow and is designed to automatically safeguard itself from overheating while in use. To one side, it has a pair of HDMI 2.1 ports, a gigabit LAN port, a pair of USB 2.0 ports, and its DC power socket. On the opposite side, you have a pair of USB 3.0 ports, a USB Type-C port, a micro SD card reader, a headphone jack, a power button, and a power LED. At the back, you have connecting pins for the external antennas. To the front, it has a reset button, and its base has 4 rubber feet, with screws to gain access to its memory card module and its M.2 NVMe SSD. The bottom plate is also connected to the mainboard via a block and thermal paste for additional cooling. This mainboard does not include an additional M.2 slot for expandable storage or a SATA expandable storage connector. So I've already booted into Windows, and its basic system information shows that its CPU is the Intel N100 processor with a base clock speed of 800 MHz, but don't be alarmed by this low base clock speed, as I'll show you in just a moment. It has 16 GB of RAM, and it's a 64-bit operating system. Its Windows version is Windows 11 Pro, and its Windows activation key is activated. For more hardware details, Ada 64 Extreme shows that its CPU has a boost clock speed of 2.9 GHz with a maximum clock speed of 3.4 GHz. It has 4 cores and 4 threads and an idle operating temperature of 47 degrees Celsius. For system memory, it has a single 16 GB 3200 DDR4 SDRAM module with a frequency of up to 1600 MHz. Its graphics processor is the Intel Alder Lake GT124EU mobile GPU with a base clock speed of 300 MHz and a boost clock speed of 1200 MHz, and it's an integrated GPU running on shared system resources. Its audio adapter is the Realtek ALC897. For storage, it comes with a Minix Neo J51 PCI Express 3.0 512 GB NVMe SSD. The M.2 slot, however, can accommodate up to 4 TB maximum. Its network adapter is the Intel AX201, and it provides dual band Wi-Fi 6 technology with Bluetooth 5.2. And its Ethernet LAN adapter is the 2.5 gigabit Realtek RTL8125 Ethernet controller. For resolution, it can display up to 4K 2160p up to 60Hz with HDR display. It can also rotate the display to portrait mode, reverse portrait, and reverse landscape. For extended display, you get a dual HDMI 2.1 output only, as its USB Type-C port is not a display port. You get 4K HDR AV1 video decoding for streaming and playing videos. So this is a 4K HDR AV1 video and it plays smoothly. However, to get HDR, you must enable it in the display settings manually. You also don't get Dolby Vision. It has HDCP protection for Netflix and other paid movie streaming services. If connected to an AV receiver, you get all surround sound audio formats. So here we have Dolby Atmos.
With powerful moving audio that transcends from channels.
Next, we have Dolby Digital Plus. This is DTS HD Master Audio. Dolby Surround. Here it can output Dolby True HD.
Next, we have the center channel.
And finally, DTS:X. Taking a look now at its gaming performance at 1080p on the lowest graphics settings, and you are getting an average of 11 FPS on the Windows version of PUBG. So here we see that it's not much of a gaming mini PC, but it can handle some low, more optimized Windows games at low to medium settings. Now, a look at its benchmarks and where it ranks on my mini PC rankings chart. First, its RAM transfer speed and its M.2 SSD read and write speeds. It has a RAM transfer speed of 5873 megabytes per second. Its M.2 SSD has a read speed of 1749 megabytes per second and a write speed of 307 megabytes per second. Next, the results of its Wi-Fi and Ethernet LAN speed tests. Based on my internet speed of 315 megabits per second, its Wi-Fi 6 5 GHz band and its Ethernet gigabit LAN port achieved the maximum speed of my network. Its 2.4 Wi-Fi 6 GHz band also performed outstanding, averaging 160 megabits per second. In testing, its CPU's single core and multi-core performance, the PC version of Geekbench 5 recorded a score of 811 single core and 2548 multi-core. In benchmarking its graphics rendering performance, 3DMark TimeSpy recorded a score of 363 with an average of less than 20 FPS. In the PC version of the AnTuTu benchmark, it scored 357,847. And in the PC Mark 10 comprehensive benchmark, it scored 2,885. Here is its video editing score and its web browsing score. So I've entered the scores on my mini PC rankings chart, and the Minix Z100 is at position number 12 at the time of making this video, which is a good position for a 12th generation Intel CPU in comparison to high-end models. On the purchase page, it comes with a 10% coupon if you would like to purchase, and you can do so using this link right here. This chart contains all of its benchmarks and Windows features, so if you would like to compare it to other mini PCs in this list, use the link provided in the description below this video. In summary, the Minix Z100 performs all its Windows tasks without issues. It has excellent high-speed Wi-Fi 6 transmission and gigabit Ethernet LAN speeds. Its 0 dB fanless design provides for quiet operation, but you have to be cautious of the hot surface the heatsink generates. Though it's not classified as a gaming mini PC, it can handle medium to low end graphics games. I attempted to install alternative operating systems such as Android x86 and Chrome OS, but unfortunately, they locked the BIOS, so it does not detect any other bootable devices. So that about wraps up this review. The Z100 and all Minix products can be found on their website and on their Amazon store. So if you are interested, see the link in the description and be sure to take advantage of the available discount coupon. Did you know that by simply clicking the thumbs up button and subscribing to my channel qualifies you to receive a giveaway when available? Every so often, I intend to do giveaways of popular products featured in my videos, and the only requirement is to subscribe to my channel and to have contributed in the comments within the last 90 days. So, to be notified when I release a new video or decide to do a giveaway, be sure to like and subscribe to my channel, stay connected, and see you in the next one.